Good morning. Happy Monday, everybody. Today, I want to take a minute and talk about maintaining weight loss. And as it relates to that particular subject, the only way to be able to maintain is to continue to work out. You are not going to be able to maintain your weight loss and not work out, because what will happen is you'll lose, let's just say you lose 30, 40, 50 pounds, and then you stop working out altogether, but you keep eating. Well, at some point, you will gain that weight back if you have no way to combat those calories. Now, if we talk about healthy eating, then yeah, if you continue to eat fruits and vegetables and you're low on your carbohydrates, or if you do high carbohydrates, low carbohydrates every other day to battle that metabolism and just do 10-minute HIIT, which is high intense interval training, you can do that. The point that I'm making is that exercise has to continue to be a part of your day-to-day regimen. There are a lot of people that still work out, and they're between the ages of 60 and 100, and they do that for their cardiovascular system. You have to continue to pump the blood through the veins, as they say. You have to continue to work out. There's just not a day where I say, oh, well, I'll never be able to work out. Even people that are quadriplegics or are paralyzed from the waist down, or paralyzed or only have one arm, or only have, like, all these different people that have these physical ailments, a lot of what you see is they'll have physical therapists that are working them out, because they know that if that body, if that muscle, if that part of their body doesn't move, you'll get bed sores. You won't be able to continue to have the same type of body if you're not moving that body. You have to work out those body parts. Even if you can't walk, you can't just never do anything with your legs. You have to work out and move those legs. It is imperative that you exercise. People say, oh, well, I can't. I have this issue, I have that issue. There are so many different exercises you can do. Even if you're 300, 400, 500 pounds. Sitting down and getting up is the start to your workout. Laying down and getting up off the floor is a start to your workout, because that's how, if you watch the show Biggest Loser, that's how people started losing weight. They say, sitting down, stand up, lay down, stand up, because that's a part of weight loss, is actually moving your body. So you want to talk about maintaining your weight? The only way to maintain that weight is to continue to exercise, continue to eat right. But at this point, it's more so if you want to go back to eating pizza and eating fried chicken and you know, eating all these things that people say are bad for you, which they're not bad for you if you eat them in moderation. But if that's how you want to continue to eat, you have to counteract that with working out. You can't just be eating pizza, fried chicken, Cheetos, Doritos, ice cream, all of that, and you never move a muscle. So I hope that this gives you a little bit of things that you need to do. And also, the article that's beneath this video is a really great article about how to maintain weight loss. So you guys have a good day, and of course, be inspired.